islands consists of 8 islands, ranging from 16 miles to 70 miles off the coast of California.
To me, the islands are one of the most beautiful places in the world. It's right there, you know, 2 hours away. You know, you don't have to go to Europe or Fiji or New Zealand, man. It's right there.
Channel Islands mean everything to me. Livelihood, fun, adventure, life. But I am
just one man. We take it for granted, but we do really appreciate it. We do really enjoy it, and that's one of the reasons why we do what we do. My name is Barry Lundgren. I'm a commercial sea urchin diver.
My name is Mark Rubaker. I'm the captain of the Janazan.
Get these guys to think it's going to be easy after they've tended, and then they have a newfound respect for what we do. Attending and learning what's going on day after day. You've earned it. You've actually earned your right to be a diver.
You gotta want it. Job we all take for granted. There's just everyday risk from leaving the harbor till we get back. Bottom line is you gotta wanna be there.
Somebody could die real easy that it doesn't have a clue on what they're doing and just jumps over and thinks it's an easy job. It's not.
The relationship between a deckhand and a captain is trust. Life is in his hands. It's just you and the elements.
It's really hard to explain to people. One guy can jump off one side of the boat and be in 20 feet, and the other guy can jump off the other side of the boat and be in 70. Sometimes you get thrown 10, 15 feet. But you don't try to go right when you're getting pushed left, you just flow with it. We call it flying. We'll work some pretty gnarly conditions underwater.
You're just by yourself.
All kinds of weird things go through your mind.
You take chances and you figure out when you've gone too far. But you still get a rush diving in the middle of nowhere knowing a white shark can be around. Mm-hmm.
we really do a good thing for the kelp beds, and it's a viable fishery. And it looks really good out there. The kelp's growing, water's been cold, there's plenty of stock, you know. If anything, they've given us days back, which is rare for the fish and game to do something like that.
Yeah, Roger. Oh, right on. Okay. We're here holding down the fort.
Sitting there picking them in the peanut coral, picking them, and all of a sudden something doesn't feel right. And I turn around and there's a bull elephant seal.
Yeah.
Rubbing his nose on my butt. Oh, my God. I swear to God, man. And I'm like, he's gonna. Yeah, and he's like scratching his nose on my basket, and I'm like, this is getting way too friendly for me, man. I'm not picking urchins or nothing. I'm just like being really cool. I don't want to get aggressive with him because I know he can just like chow me if he wants to. And he went across my back. He's got me pinned in the peanut coral, and I'm spitting out of my regular. I mean, I'm face down, like, you know, monkey uncle trying to give up wrestling kind of thing. I mean, it's a ton seal trying to get out of the water, and he's using me as a stepping stone. You know, I was a hose length away, and Jerry's like, is there any more in there? And I'm like, no, dude, it's done. You know, I just wanted to get out of there. And closest call I'd ever have with the elephant seal.
Yeah, I'd be walking like a cowboy.
I've never been in the corporate world, but I can almost guarantee there's a tighter bond between fishermen.
There's just a general respect that we have for each other, and as fishermen, that's across the board.
You know, we all have our days where we're competitive toward each other, and, you know, we do a lot of heckling, but at the end of the day, we all got each other's back.
More world players than there was 10 years ago, when Santa Barbara urchins have always kind of been the best on the market besides the Japanese product and their aquaculture over there. But now there's Russia, China, Chile, all over the world there's players. They're eating a lot of sushi, which is really good for us. commercial fishing in 1979 and started diving sea urchins February of 1980. And I'm hoping to do it for another 10 years. A lot of people think about it, dream about it, but a lot of people don't really get to live it. I feel extra special and really fortunate that I had everything that life could give.
I have been searching all of my days.
I couldn't have had a better life in the last 25 years.
Many a road, you know, I've been walking on.
The price of fuel, the market, the economy, and everything, you know, I just get sick of reading the paper, opening and looking at the news, because I just prefer to look at everything as, you know, the glass is, half full.
As the days keep turning into night.
That's what it takes to, survive in the business and be good at what you do.
Well, I have been quietly standing in the shade. All of my days. Watch the sky breaking on the promise that we made. All of this rain. And I've been trying to find what's been in my mind. As the days keep turning into night. Many a night I found myself with no friend standing near. All of my days. I cried aloud, I shook my hands at what I'm doing here. All of these days. For I look around me and my eyes confound me, and it's just too bright. As the days keep turning into night.